वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर अर्चना सावरकर, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, श्री आरएलटी कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस, अकोला. टुडे वी हैव टू सी द टॉपिक रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ स्कॉलियोडॉन. नाउ एज यू नो द स्कॉलियोडॉन इज एक्वेटिक एनिमल. इट लिव्स इन सी वॉटर. ऑब्वियसली इट यूटिलाइजेस द ऑक्सीजन which is dissolved in water. Means the scolodon or dogfish shows aquatic mode of respiration. Now see the respiratory system of scolodon. This respiratory system of scolodon we have to study under three heads. First is the respiratory organs. Respiratory. So let us see one by one. See the respiratory organs in case of scolodon. In case of scolodon, the respiratory organs are five pairs of gill pouches. These gill pouches are arranged on either lateral side of the pharyngeal wall. We can see in this diagram. This is the mouth of scolodon is opening. Then this mouth opens into this cavity. This cavity is the buccal cavity. Then this buccal cavity, it continues into pharynx. This is the pharyngeal cavity, which opens into esophagus. This is the position of esophagus. Now here you can observe on either lateral side of the pharynx there are gill pouches. There are five pairs of gill pouches. Here you can observe 1, 2. See again 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. These are the five pairs of gill pouches which contains gills, and these are the actual respiratory organs in case of scolodon. These gill pouches opens on inner side of the side of pharynx, and this opening is called as internal branchial aperture. This is the internal branchial aperture. The opening of gill pouch on the inner side of this pharyngeal wall. Then this gill pouch opens to the exterior, and this opening is known as external branchial aperture. This opening is the external branchial aperture. On the inner side of pharynx, the opening of gill pouch is internal branchial aperture, and on the opposite side, that is on the exterior side, this is the external branchial aperture. This external branchial aperture is also known as external gill slits. Now there are five external gill slits, that is the outer opening of gill pouch. Now here observe one thing. These 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the complete gills, and these two are the incomplete gills. So these gills are the respiratory organ, and that's why we have to see first the structure of these gills. Gills are also known as, the complete gill is holobranch and the incomplete gill is hemibranch or demibranch. On the side of pharynx, here you can observe the cartilaginous structure like this. This is the gill arch, which continues into the septum, and on the both side of septum there are gill lamellae. On these four position 1, 2, 3, and 4, there are both gill lamellae, means these are the complete gill or holobranch, and this one here you can observe only one gill lamella is present. This is the incomplete gill or hemibranch. It is also known as demibranch. So see the structure of this complete gill or holobranch. This is the cartilaginous portion, and this cartilaginous portion is known as visceral arch or the gill arch. This is gill arch. This gill arch continues as a septum, and this is known as interbranchial septum, which divides the gill pouches. This interbranchial septum divides this gill pouches. So this is the interbranchial septum. Interbranchial septum or gill septum. Now observe the structure of this gill arch or the visceral arch. This gill arch is supported with the help of cartilage, and this cartilage is called as epibranchial cartilage. This is the epibranchial cartilage. This epibranchial cartilage continues as a branchial ray, which gives support to this interbranchial septum. This is the branchial ray. Branchial ray. Here, in this gill arch, again we can observe some muscles which are present here. This interbranchial septum is covered by epithelial lining. It is covered by epithelial lining as well as the mucous membrane. This mucous membrane of this interbranchial septum, it raised and gives rise to leaf-like structure. This leaf-like structure, it constitute gill lamellae. Like this, on the anterior side, it raised into number of leaf-like structure, and this leaf-like structure on the anterior side is known as anterior gill lamella. Likewise, on the posterior side, again, we can observe the leaf-like structure or leaf-like projection of this interbranchial septum, and this is the posterior gill lamella. Here in holobranch, this is the structure of complete gill or holobranch. Here in holobranch, both anterior as well as posterior gill lamellae are present. But as I have said, there is one hemibranch which is present near the hyoid arch. Here we can observe only the posterior gill lamella. Anterior gill lamella is absent here, and that's why it is incomplete gill or holobranch. This hyoidean gill is the incomplete gill, and other four are the holobranch, that is complete gills. So again, come to our point, the structure of holobranch. What you have seen, This is the visceral arch or the gill arch. Then interbranchial septum. This gill arch is supported with cartilaginous structure, that is epibranchial cartilage, which gives rise to branchial ray. These are anterior gill lamella, posterior gill lamella. Again, these are provided with nerve fibers. This holobranch is provided with nerve fibers. Here we can observe the pre-traumatic nerve and post-traumatic nerve. This is the pre-traumatic nerve and this one is the post-traumatic nerve. Here, this is the position of pre-traumatic and post-traumatic nerves. This gill or the holobranch is again supplied with the nutrient vessel. There is presence of this large vessel and this is the nutrient vessel. Now see about the blood supply to this holobranch. It is richly supplied with blood vessel, afferent blood vessel as well as the efferent blood vessel. Here we can observe a large blood vessel and this is known as afferent blood vessel. This is the afferent blood vessel. This afferent blood vessel carries venous blood or the deoxygenated blood from all part of the body towards the respiratory organ, that is gill. This afferent blood vessel contains venous blood, impure blood. Again, there are two blood vessels here and here. These are the efferent blood vessel. This is the anterior efferent blood vessel and this is posterior efferent blood vessel, which carries pure blood, oxygenated blood. This is about the respiratory organs. Here these gill pouches which contains gills are the respiratory organ. Now see the second part of this respiratory system, that is mechanism of respiration, how the actual respiration takes place. Second part of this respiratory system is the mechanism of respiration. This mechanism of respiration involves two processes. The first one is the inspiration and the second process is the expiration. Inspiration means taking in oxygen which is dissolved in water, that is the inspiration, and expiration giving out carbon dioxide, that is expiration. Now see how inspiration takes place. Here at the position of this mouth, the hypobranchial muscles get contracted. What is the first step? The hypobranchial muscle get contracted. Due to contraction of this hypobranchial muscle, what happens? These gill arches expand. These gill arches expand, which lowers the buccopharyngeal cavity. That's why the buccopharyngeal cavity enlarges. And due to this enlargement of buccopharyngeal cavity, here the pressure decreases than that of the outer pressure. The mouth opens and the water enters through this mouth like this. Means water enters through this mouth in this buccopharyngeal cavity. This is the process of inspiration. Then next process is the expiration. By the action of adductor muscle, mouth gets closed. Observe the another side. We can divide this figure into two sides. This is suppose our A side and this is suppose the B side of this figure. In B side of this figure, we have seen the inspiration. Now see the A side. In expiration, what happens? Due to the action of adductor muscle, the mouth gets closed. This is the closed mouth. Then interbranchial muscle contract. Interbranchial muscle contract. And that's why the floor of buccopharyngeal cavity raise. Due to raising of this floor of buccopharyngeal cavity, the volume here in this cavity decreases. At this position, what is the position here? This external branchial aperture is closed. Now, due to raising of this buccopharyngeal cavity, the pressure increases here and the water, it finds its way through the gill lamina. Means now this water is pushed over this gill laminae and the water enters in the gill pouches, it bathes the gill laminae and goes outside the body. This process is the expiration. This is about mechanism of respiration. And the third and most important part is physiology of respiration. The physiology of respiration. The physiology of respiration means how the actual respiration takes place. Means it includes exchange of gases. The physiology of respiration include exchange of gases. Now here, see again, when this water, it flows along these gill pouches, what happens? These gill lamellae, anterior as well as posterior gill lamellae, get bathed. Means the water flows on this gill lamellae. At this position, what happens? The water which contains dissolved oxygen, this oxygen diffuses in the blood vessels of this gill lamellae. These gill lamellae are richly supplied with network of blood vessels. So the oxygen which is dissolved in water here at this position get absorbed in the blood vessel. At the same time, this afferent branchial artery, this afferent branchial artery which contains venous blood, means venous blood means the blood which is rich in carbon dioxide. Here, when oxygen gets diffused in the blood, at the same time, carbon dioxide from this venous blood given to the outside and it is given to the water. Means here gaseous exchange takes place. Oxygen enters in the blood and carbon dioxide is given outside the blood. at the position of this gill lamellae, oxygen diffuses in the blood and carbon dioxide is given to the water. Means the exchange of gases takes place here in the region of this gill lamella, and this type of respiration is known as external respiration. This is the external respiration. Now, here what happened? The oxygen get dissolved in the blood. Now the blood get purified, and this purified blood, oxygenated blood, enters into this efferent bronchial blood vessel. This efferent bronchial blood vessel carries this pure blood, oxygenated blood, towards the tissue, to the inner body part. In the inner body part, at the position of tissue, there is already digested food material. From the digested food material, by the oxidation of digested food material, energy is produced, and as a byproduct, carbon dioxide gas is also produced. Means there, in the deeper part of body, at the region of tissue, there is presence of carbon dioxide as a product of metabolism. Now at the level of tissue, what happens? This oxygenated blood, which is rich in oxygen, it gives oxygen to the tissue and takes carbon dioxide from the tissue. Means again, exchange of gases takes place at the region of tissue. This exchange of gases is known as internal respiration. This is the internal respiration. Thus, the exchange of gases takes place at two places, at the region of gill lamella as well as at a region of tissue. This is about the physiology of respiration. Now again, one thing I have to tell you here, at the position of this hyoid arch, there are two openings of spiracle. These are the spiracles. Actually, these spiracles do not have any functional role in the process of respiration. These are the vestigial organs, because they do not possess gills or they do not open outside the body. But sometime what happens, the mouth is engaged in other activity. That time the water enters through the spiracle inside the mouth to this buccopharyngeal cavity. Thus, students, in this lecture we have seen the respiratory system of scolodon, which includes the three major parts, that is the respiratory organ, which contains five pair of gill pouches with gills, then mechanism of respiration, which include inspiration and expiration process, and the physiology of respiration, which includes the external respiration as well as the internal respiration. So, students, we have finished this point, respiratory system of scolodon. We will stop here. Thank you. Thank you very much.